Dr. David Kimbrough and Dr. Randall Hughes work to unlock the secrets of the intertidal zone, where the land meets the sea.
There are many types of biodiversity. Randall has studied how diversity within a single species might help salt marshes. The number of different plants and animals matters as well.
The marsh can be a pretty rough place for plants to live. It's a pretty harsh environment. And so we know that there are several of the animals that live in the marsh that can actually help the plants survive better. And so in the process of investigating how mussels and fiddler crabs affect marsh plants, Althea went out to Wakulla Beach to do some sampling, and she made some interesting observations about another potential facilitation in the marsh.
So these are my experimental plots. You can see I have these sort of walkways in between.
Althea knew that mussels and marsh cordgrass benefited each other, but
I noticed certainly from sampling in the marsh that you'll have these really high densities of mussels within the limonium.
Each of these plots contain different combinations of both. She charted their progress to measure how beneficial each species was to the other. But there can be too much of a good thing.
So maybe at a certain density, the mussels could be either providing nutrients or stability for the plants, but at higher densities, they might actually crowd out the plant too much.
Randall has also tried to tease apart relationships between different plants in the marsh.
So to try to understand this relationship between Spartina and juncus and snails, we've done a series of experiments in the lab and in the field. And so if you have needlerush and snails, the Spartina actually does better than if you have just one or the other. And so this is another case where there's some benefits to living with other species in the marsh.
In the Grass on the Reef is funded by the National Science Foundation.